Here's the big question. Do you believe that money is a form of speech? Do we want freedom of thought, freedom of speech, freedom to hold our own money, to actually own property? Or do we need permission for all these things? Permission from daddy. Most money transactions today need permission. We rely on a person, a bookkeeper, and we have to get the okay from them to use our own money. Depending on what country you live in, this is either a small inconvenience or a very big one. But point being, if you have to ask, can you even call the money yours? You can try hoarding cash or carrying around a bag of coins like an insane person, but try purchasing a vehicle or a home or hot water or electricity with cash and see what happens. We like to think it's science fiction, imagining a world where tyrants capture all information, track your exact location, record everything you say, but unfortunately, we are already there. That is not the future. That is today. What's worse is that this data isn't just hoarded by government. It's actively sold around. It's leaked by companies on accident. It's stolen by fatzos who have access to a computer in their parents' basement. But there is hope. Don't ever take the black pill. There is so much to be hopeful about, thanks to a certain property, a certain universal truth about how our universe works. It is easier to create a puzzle than to solve it. It's easier to scramble something up than to unscramble it. That one thing makes cryptography possible and gives the common man an advantage, even against a stronger power. Cryptography can be used to make speech, to make money private. Bitcoin emerged in 2008 by immaculate conception and remains the only cryptocurrency with a chance to persist 100 years from now. Dumb people will tell me, oh, Bitcoin, what makes Bitcoin so special? Might as well use Beanie Babies. There's no difference between a Bitcoin and a Beanie Baby. Listen, if Beanie Babies could be broken down into tiny pieces and sent over the internet, if there was actually a fixed limit in the number of Beanie Babies that existed, if it was easy to detect what is a real Beanie Baby and what's a fake, then yes, yes, I would support Beanie Babies as world money. I would be a Beanie Baby maximalist. But they don't. Only Bitcoin has those properties, and only Bitcoin is truly scarce. Bitcoin won't solve every problem in the world. Rent seekers will still look to insert themselves. Traditional banking will always exist. But what Bitcoin offers people is a choice, an option, freedom. All that is needed is education. People have to learn. People need to wake up and understand the power they have. As countries around the world become more connected, people are going to realize, wait a minute, this money I'm told to use by the government, what makes it special over that country's money? I'm to use this because why exactly? Just because the world appears stuck, working a certain way, doesn't mean change can't happen. A collective agreement between people can change everything. We create our own reality. In 2018, I went to the Met Museum in New York, and you know, there was all these different exhibits, all this art, all this history, ancient cultures, sticks and stones, and sticks and stones. We spent the whole day walking around, and before leaving, I finally went down this long hallway to this last room that had a special exhibit showcasing the Catholic Church. And as you walk down the hall, this haunting music was playing. And it gets louder and louder and louder until entering this massive auditorium with white mannequins all around in this elaborate dress, gold and blue and black robes and hats with jewels and embroidery, and it's just hitting me. All these religious symbols and this grandeur and spectacle, and it just hits me. Now, who knows what the curators were trying to portray, but I felt something. It was like a massive wall crushing me. Say whatever you want about religion, blah, 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 show me the evidence. Well, in that room with that music blasting, I felt the power of a practice and a culture that is thousands of years old. Something that shaped history, that impacted all aspects of life all over the world. Humans with a shared purpose could create something larger than themselves that felt almost from another world. I walked away from that, not converted, but I understood the power of faith.